Praise the Lord and welcome to another exciting day. I'm having a great time doing this devotional. I'm excited about the power of resurrection. I have hope that my tomorrow will be greater than my today. I have expectation that God will take me higher and take me to greater realms of glory and grace. Beloved, it doesn't matter where you are this morning. I am going straight into this word. May the angel of the Lord bring fresh glory into your life and change your location. You ought to look at every debt in your life and say, hey, I'm leaving you all behind. Look at every sickness in your life and tell them, I'm leaving you behind. You need to look at every relationship debacle you are facing. Tell them, I'm leaving you behind. Tell every hurt, I'm leaving you behind. I will no longer be here. I am risen because Jesus rose. Ooh, I'm going to keep talking about it, beloved, until it will come out of my toes, until it will come out of my mind, out of my pores, because that's how we conquer the power and the dominance of circumstances, and we reign in this life. Hey, you remember Romans 5? He said that those that receive abundance of grace, verse 17, and the gift of righteousness, they shall reign in this life. If I know how to position myself so that every time God looks at me, he gives me grace. Glory to God. And every time he looks at me, he gives me more grace. He gives me more grace. He says, I'm going to reign in this life. So what do? I keep positioning myself in faith. I keep positioning myself in humility. I keep positioning myself in his righteousness. And grace will keep getting poured. And keep getting poured until I begin to reign. Like Jesus reigned over all principality, over all power. Hey, you can reign in Jesus' name. Glory to God. Oh, it is the blessing of resurrection. Can't you tell I'm excited? Come pray with us. It's tomorrow, 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. We will be seeking the Lord. We will be beholding his face. That's one thing I love about God. Every time you wake up, he resumes his plan and begins to work in your life and begins to help you. Come on, let's go to downtown and pray our state on into the glory and pray Atlanta into the glory and pray College Park, East Point, Union City. It doesn't matter, Fayetteville, Stone Mountain. It doesn't matter what your city's named. Let us pray them into the glory. Hallelujah. And let me return to these two women in Matthew chapter 28. This is the word that the angel gave them. And go quickly and tell his disciples that he is risen from the dead. And behold, he goeth before you into Galilee. There shall ye see him. Lo, I have told you. Amen. Oh, let me tell you three exciting things the Holy Spirit gave me as I was reading that text. Number one, because they went to that grave, these women received their ministry. Remember, beloved, up until that time, women were non-entities. They didn't belong. They had a separate court of women in the temple. Paul even said they should ask their husbands if they had questions in church. Come on, beloved. Every woman on earth ought to celebrate the Lord Jesus. He gave you rights. He gave you worth. Oh, I love what the Bible said about the woman with the issue of blood. Jesus said, somebody touched me. And nobody became a somebody. Jesus used two people that didn't matter in the arena of things, and gave them the first message of salvation, the first message of resurrection. They were commissioned as the first evangelists of the New Testament. Woo! Glory to God. What will happen to you, beloved? I said it last week, and I'll say it again. When you come out of that thing, you will become his evangelist. You will become a healing minister. You will become a prosperity minister. You will become an emotional healing minister. You will dance to the Lord. You will preach life into people. Beloved, they were commissioned to their ministry. That's the wonderful blessing. Look at number two. That's so exciting. They received the word for their fearful brethren. Somebody needs to get a word for you. Many times you are trapped in where you are, and somebody has to keep going with the Lord and come back and bring you a word to tell you, don't die in depression. Don't sit where you are. He has risen. Did you notice that it was not sinners they were sent to? It was their brethren. It was believers. So go tell them that Jesus has risen from the dead. I know you're depressed because God didn't deliver him like you wanted. God did not send an angel and kill off everybody. Beloved, he's trying to get us saved. Many times what pride desires is the worst thing that can happen to us because we don't have the vision to see tomorrow. But God sees better. These women carried the word of resurrection. The Lord has risen. And I'm telling you this morning, the Lord has risen. The Lord has risen. You cannot die there. The Lord has risen, beloved. He has risen. Come on, get up. The Lord has risen. The Lord has risen. Amen. I'll see you tomorrow. We love you. We're praying for you. Remember, come pray with us. Amen. God bless you. Bye-bye.